I'm stronger, I'm wiser, I'm better, much better. When I look back over all you brought me through,
praise the Lord, saints. Hope that everyone is doing well today. I'm Brother Marshall, and thank you for joining us for Cultivating Spiritual Excellence. Our host is none other than Dr. Marshall, and tonight we have with us our Deacon Donovan. Before we get into tonight's program, you can start getting your Bibles, your pen and paper handy, and let us pray. Father God, I want to thank you for another opportunity to come before you, Lord. Lord, I thank you for your many blessings and for caring for us enough to give us these many chances. I'm praying tonight, Lord, that each of our listeners, their hearts will be turned to you, Lord, Father God. I'm praying for anyone that is going through a tough time, Lord, Father God, anyone that has ailments or sickness, Lord, in their body. I'm praying, Lord, that you will heal them. I'm praying that tonight, this message, Father God, will lead anyone that had gone astray, Father God, from you, Lord. I pray that they will come back to you, Lord. I'm praying, Lord, that they will trust you. I pray that we will have a heart that is pleasing in your sight, Lord. I pray for our minister tonight, Lord, Father God, Dr. Marshall, as he's bringing your word, that you just encourage him, Lord, Father God. You'll speak in and through him, Lord. Father God, I pray that you'll continue to bless us, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. And let me turn the rest of the program over to our pastor at this time.
Praise the Lord. Glory to God. It's an honor to have you joining us today. My name is Dr. Marshall, pastor of Mustard Seed Tabernacle of Praise Brooklyn, New York. We truly feel honored to have you join us tonight on Choice Radio 92.9. It's your life, your salvation, and your choice. Now, if we have been a blessing to you, please consider being a blessing to us at Choice Gospel Network. Glory to God. Thank you. Well, we are pretty excited tonight to continue our message. Jesus is the Son of God. And the program is Cultivating Spiritual Excellence. Excellence to prepare, improve, or develop by careful attention, training, study, devoting time and thought to cultivate a spiritual attitude towards God. And spiritual relating to the human spirit or soul, as opposed to the material and physical things of this world. Now God is the Spirit, and they that worship Him must worship Him in spirit and in truth. John 4:24. Excellence has to do with, we know Daniel is preferred over the presidents and the princes because he had an excellent spirit. And that spirit is none other but the Holy Ghost. Praise God. Now we had continued this message, Jesus is the Christ, the Son and of the living God. And just to highlight a few things, we said that He was the Logos, Greek meaning the Word. He is the written Word of God. And we also touch on Rhema, that He is the spoken Word of God, a Greek word also. Now, Jesus Christ and His God nature is well established throughout the New Testament. Here are some scriptures that we touched on last week concerning Jesus Christ. He is called God by the Apostle John. In John 1:1, it says that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. We see that He is also called God by the Apostle Thomas. We always associate Thomas as a doubter. But Thomas answered and said unto Him, My Lord and my God. In John 20:28. So we see, although he doubted at first, you know, some folks have to see to believe. But is greater is he that who has not seen and yet believe. He's called God by God the Father. But unto the Son he says, Thy throne, O God, is forever and ever. A scepter of righteousness is the scepter of thy kingdom. In Hebrews 1:8. So we see that it will refer to Jesus as God as many times in the scripture. Well, the text selected here was from John 1:1-18, and we had read a few verses. But tonight I want to read those 18 verses. Do you have your Bible, your notebook? Let's read together. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made. In Him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. The same came for a witness to bear witness of that light, that all men through him might believe. Now John, he was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighted every man that cometh into the world. So we see John was not light, but he was speaking about someone else who was Jesus Christ. He was in the world, and the world received him not. He came unto his own, and they received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh, and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. John bare witness of him, and cried, saying, This was he of whom I speak. He that cometh after me is preferred before me, for he was before me. And of his fullness have all we received, and grace for grace. For the law was given by Moses, but grace and truth came by Jesus Christ. No man had seen God at any time. The only begotten Son, which is in the bosom of the Father, he has declared him. So here John is testifying that he was not a light, but he was like a forerunner. Praise be to God. He came before. As we, you know, we are not forerunners, but we are running after, because Christ came. Now, Jesus Christ is the Son of God and is not an angel. We had clarified that. The activity of Jesus Christ is not Michael. When you see the angel of the Lord, he is Yahweh, which refers to God. And we saw the word, a next theological word, the theophanies, the appearance of deity, or the appearance of God in human form. Now let's look at the scripture where there's a theophanies in Genesis 12 and 7. Let's look at that. Genesis 12 and 7. We see here, it says, "And the Lord appeared unto Abram and said, Unto thy seed I will give this land. And yea, he builded an altar unto the Lord who appeared unto him." So the presence, the theophanies that appeared to Abraham, was God manifested in human form. The theophanies. Praise be to God. The Lord appeared unto Abraham. God is a spirit now. So he have to take on some form to be recognized, because no man could see God and live. We saw that here. And no man had seen God anytime. So the theophanies is a manifestation of God in human form, which manifested to Abraham. You know, God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and truth. So when Abraham, when God appeared to Abraham in human form, he worshiped him. Praise the Lord. Now, do you understand what is a spirit, or the composite of a spirit? A spirit, that means he is incorporeal, which means with no material form, body or substance. Spiritual, something that has no material or physical form or substance. Something that can be described in the form of a spirit. Do you believe in ghosts? Praise the Lord. Ghosts and spirit, similar composition. No flesh, no bones, but there's spirits. Praise be to God. And let us look at the creations of angels. Angels were created by Jesus Christ. The fact that all creation to praise the Lord, angels are created beings. In Psalm 148, verses 2 and 5, it says, "Praise ye him, all his angels. Praise ye him, all his hosts. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for he commanded and they were created." So all the angels and all was created by Christ. Pre-existence. He was pre-existence. Now the time of creation of angels is not mentioned in the Bible. They were present when the earth was created. So their creation long before the earth. Now angels are creatures and not the creator. Yet they are separate order of creation and distinct from human beings. In 1 Corinthians 6:3 says, "Know ye not that we shall judge angels? How much more things that pertain to this life?" So we will judge angels. It's unbelievable, but that's the scripture. 1 Corinthians 6:3. Angels are spirit beings. They have good angels, and they're considered ministering servants, because angels are actually servants in Hebrews 1:14. Now the evil spirits are called demons or unclean spirit in Luke 8:2 and Luke 8:24 and verse 26. Now though God is a spirit being, this does not mean that the angels are infinite in nature as God. Rather, they are finite. Angels are not infinite, they are finite. Praise be to God. Now let's continue on our text as we go along. depicting that John was a forerunner of Jesus Christ. There was a man sent from John there's a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for a witness to bear witness of that light, that all men through him might believe. So we see John was a forerunner. Now John was not the Logos. John was human. But he was sent by God, commissioned by God, to be before Christ, to prepare the way of the Lord. Glory to God. John was a witness to bear witness of that light, that all men through him might believe. John's purpose was to give testimony concerning Jesus Christ, who will be the lead man. He will be the Savior. And if we believe in him, we shall be saved. So he came to publish it to the masses. Matter of fact, to his people. He went about preaching. John was not light. The ministry of John the Baptist is similar to the ministry of Christians today. We are to give personal witness and testimony concerning Jesus Christ, who is the light of the world. And John elaborates on the theme of Christ is the light in a series of relationship to the world in general, to the Jews and to the disciples and to the world at large. That Jesus was the true light. And Christ is the true light, or genuine or real light, which lighted every man that cometh into the world. Praise be to God. That's verse 9. That was the true light, which lighted every man that cometh into the world. But you know what? He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. Jesus, being on earth, was still the God-man. And still, he still had all the powers of God, but he wasn't functioning as God. So he had to lay down his glory. And we see that in some scriptures as we go along. He had to lay down his glory, but no man could see God and live. And no man really know how Jesus looked. I don't believe there was a painting of Jesus or a picture of Jesus. For some reason, God don't want you to worship or bow down to no image, no false image, and no statue or nothing made like God. He's a spirit. So they have no painting. But men in their mind figure that he have to look a certain way, but they have no picture in reality. You want to get fooled, you would believe what's out there, but they don't have no picture of Jesus, no painting. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Because he's a spirit. Now the true light came. Christ is the true light, or the genuine real light, and he lighted every man that cometh into the world. So every man that born have some light in him. And you know, while I was studying, I realized that once a man is born, he lives forever. He don't die. But the opportunity to live with God in heaven or to go to hell is your choice. Once you're born, that's it. You're born. You become a living soul. That's why God wants to save man. And don't want man go to destruction. Let's read some more. Glory to God. He came unto his own, and his own receive him not. But as many as receive him, them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. So this spiritual birth spoken of is not of blood, is not of a lineage, Jewish or Greek or whatever you're born. No. This has to do, it's a spiritual birth. It is not of the will of the flesh or carnal desire. It is not of the will of man, human origin. It is of God. This birth is a supernatural birth from God himself. And in order to receive that supernatural birth, Christ had to come himself. He had to be the ultimate sacrifice. And here John is saying, this Logos, God, the very God, came in the flesh. Hallelujah. So it's only one word. When you check it, it is one word of God, the Logos. It can't have two words of God. It's one. It doesn't have no second edition of Jesus. You know, one time one guy came up with some theory saying that he wanted to write a Bible with the exact word of God. It can't happen. Not even the disciples write the exact word. The disciples was there, and if three of them was there, whatever he said, it came to the same conclusion, but not word for word. So the word is already written and settled in heaven, and Jesus is already the word. And now we're giving a rhema word here tonight. Praise be to God. Glory. Hallelujah. The word was made flesh, we see here. Glory to God. As we read, let's read verse 13, it says, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Jesus always say that he used, I'm the way, the truth, and life. He always talk about being truthful. You ever notice that? He is the truth. Now, if there's a truth, you know there are lies. Glory to God. Hallelujah. He was made flesh, dwelt among us. The verb here, translated, means to tabernacle or to live in tents. The author testifies that we beheld his glory. The disciples, they marveled as they walked with Jesus. And they see the type of things he did. And, you know, a lot of folks always have testimonies, or they went to heaven, they talk to Jesus, they walk around heaven, and they talk like if Jesus is their friend. Yeah, they say he's a friend, I stick it closer than a brother. But remember, God is holy. And if Jesus said, no man had ascended to heaven anytime, is the Son declare him. So Jesus came to declare who God is. He's the Son of God. Who better to introduce you to the Heavenly Father? But the Son, or a Son. And we have the Paracletos, the one who comes alongside to help us. Glory to God. Now let's go to our fourth point here. The Word was made flesh. Let's clarify it. The Word made flesh and dwelt among us. Jesus is proclaimed as the Messiah by several individuals, including John the Baptist. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and we put emphasis on that. And the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God, and all things were made by him, and without him there's nothing made that was made. So we see that he was pre-existent. He was there. Hallelujah. Glory to God. He was in the beginning, the pre-incarnate Son of the living God. Let's read verse 16. Of his fullness have all we received, and grace for grace. You see, the law couldn't give us grace. Law was the schoolmaster. But Jesus brought grace, and we get saved. By grace are we saved through faith. That no one should boast. Grace is a free gift. Gift without favor. We don't have to do anything to be saved. We just have to accept Jesus as Lord and believe that he died for us, that we might have life, and that we might have it more abundantly. Free gift from God. And a gift is something, you don't pay for your gift. If you pay for something, that means it's not a gift. So God gave his Son, for God so loved the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever should believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And you could only give what you have. Jesus is eternal. So he could give us eternal life if we believe in him, and if we trust him, and if we believe in the sacrifice that he died for us and paid on Calvary. Praise be to God. It's simply believe and confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. And the Logos came among men. He came in the flesh and dwelt among us. Jesus walked about with men. He traveled the dusty streets of Galilee, and man was able to behold his glory. Jesus wasn't here to show off. He was God, and the very God, the very Christ, the Messiah, the Messiah, the long promised Messiah. And when he walked, there was not a need that they brought to him that he didn't take care of. They brought blind people, and they received their sight. cripple walk. Even he raised the dead. And you notice by his word, he was the Logos. And he used this Rhema, the spoken word. Even when the devil tempted him, he said, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. And the devil knew he was God, but he realized that Jesus was not functioning as God. He came as a humble state in the flesh to restore man. He wanted the spirit, not the flesh he wanted. Our flesh will be decomposed, but he wanted the spirit that was in the flesh. Glory to God. Now we will take a small break and we will continue the message. Glory to God.